What was the please stop school presentation that you witnessed? Someone in my class did a book report on the dictionary. The teacher was pissed. All of us students thought it was hilarious. Never heard the end of the presentation. Not a presentation, but during our school assemblies we often had student performers, which were usually musically inclined individuals or theater kids doing a scene monologue. One kid decided to do a stand-up comedy routine about a girl giving him a blowjob. So awkward, and the principal had to interrupt him. In college, someone was doing a presentation on Nelson Mandela and kept referring to Africans as African Americans. This was in fucking college. Our bio finals were to present on any topic that was related to biology. A group was presenting on types of protection for sex. Not once did they refer to any body parts or fluids by their scientific names. So, yes, they literally had dick, cum, and pussy on slides and read off them. Everyone kept glancing over at our professor, who had this look like he was just constantly cleaning his glasses because he couldn't believe what he was witnessing. They got Kentucky fucked on grading. The one where my school got ripped off by paying a guy who claimed to be on SpongeBob to come talk to us about drugs. He did look kind of like Tom Kenny, I guess. Not at school, but when I was in high school, my church youth group went to this church camp. For those uninitiated, Thursday nights are normally the really emotional nights. Well, this camp was different. Thursday night, the guy that started the camp comes on stage and begins giving a bunch of middle school and high school boys and girls the sex talk. All I remember from that night was the quote, "Just because there's a hole there doesn't mean you have to stick something in it." Quote. In speech 101 in college, we had to pick a children's book and voice act each character. That was it. That was the entire assignment. Well, one student decided to take it to the next level. He chose a Berenstain Bear book and decided to not only do voice acting for every single one of the characters, but also act it out. It was physically uncomfortable to watch this guy scramble around the room and pretend to be bears and other animals. It was not well done. It was awful. I've told this on Reddit a few times, but it's truly unforgettable. Smart kid in the class was giving a deeply sourced PowerPoint presentation on religion in Europe. He opens up his files, proceeds to click on his project named N*GGER. He says, "Clearly I wasn't really paying any attention when I named my file." He gives the presentation. He stutters and sweats bullets while we watch in utter disbelief. The word is sitting there on the top of the file heading the whole time. This was during a study abroad semester while attending a cultural communication class. He had to rot in his own shit after that. In 1984, when I was in 6th grade, each class did a winter concert. The 8th grade football team sang "I'm Dreaming of a Black Christmas" in blackface. Green Bay, Wisconsin. Bayview Middle School. Edit. It was 1984. Not 1985. I studied, went to school for computer security. In an introduction to computer security course, we had to do a project on social engineering. A student decided that for his project he was going to find a way to gain access to a chosen website. He found a small local business website, identified that the domain was registered to an email address from a local ISP, called the ISP to reset the password. They asked him for his last four of his SSN. So he hung up. He found the phone number of the business, so called them and pretended to be from the ISP, offering 3 months free if the person did a 5-question survey. They accepted and answered some BS questions. Then he asked for the last four of the guy's SSN, which they gave no problem. He then called the ISP with the last four, got them to reset the password of the email account. He then logged into the email and used it to get the domain registrar to send a password reset to the email, which he used to reset the password of the domain account and deleted the email. He recorded all phone calls and screenshotted the whole process. As he presented all these, we kept expecting him to say, but that would be illegal. So I didn't do X. But he went all the way. The professor finally stopped him after he said he logged into the domain registrar and told him to destroy everything and never speak of it again. I think the professor was a bit nicer than he could have been. Potentially to the point of accomplice telling him to destroy evidence. When I was a ninth grade student, we had to present the poems we made in English class. Most people wrote about embracing their culture, loving their friends, etc. And then there was that one kid who recited a lifestyle poem which compared fat people to beached whales and said that people who don't work out will die before they're 20. Edit O Reddit and their Hitler discourse. We love to see it. An anti-bullying campaign. They spent most of the presentation explaining different types and ways to bully, harass people. Bullying increased in school and everything got 10 times worse now that the students were more educated on the subject. My sophomore year, we had to make a presentation about any person that made an impact on the world. That was inspirational. Someone chose Hitler. When I was in high school, a girl from an absurdly wealthy family gave a presentation on why the rich are just as oppressed as anyone. This was in a normal public school in Kentucky where about 90% of the students were middle class at best. You could feel the eyes rolling in that room. Compared to some other stories in here, this is minor. But it was a group project for one of my literature classes. There were 5 people in this group. According to the rubric for this assignment, everyone was supposed to have equal speaking parts. One of the members in this group would just not stop talking. Half of their presentation was just her talking, and she went on about each of her slides for like 5 minutes. The rest of her group members had like 1 or 2 slides each, and she had IIRC 5 or 6. She would also interject into the other group members' parts to add her opinions. The look on my professor's face screamed, "Just shut up already." Every time she talked, "It's me. I did this." I cringe about it to this day. Nearly 20 years later, I was 16 and in high school. My high school was going to do a spring talent show. I wanted to be in the talent show and show off my talents. The problem was, my actual talents are not ones that I could show off at a talent show. So I decided to try singing. I have never sung in my life. I have never had voice lessons. I was in my prime weeb stage and chose an anime song to sing. I didn't know any actual Japanese. I had just memorized the lyrics from hearing the song so many times. Luckily, I didn't make it past auditions. But several people saw an overweight girl in a Sailor Moon shirt try to sing Butterfly, despite having never done any singing or voice training ever in her life. Nearly 20 years later, and remembering it keeps me awake at night. Psychology class. Our final was to research into a presentation on a mental illness. One group chose necrophilia, started with the first slide saying, "Let's crack open a cold one." Edit, thank you for the silver laughing face. This was a Spanish class in college, and I think the assignment was something like talk about your best friend or some such. Just kind of a softball assignment so you could practice using the vocabulary. And one classmate's friend was evidently a friend with benefits. Not a literal presentation really. But we had an assembly in high school where the students that helped plan homecoming would announce the nominations for homecoming court. It always had a cute little theme and like a short skit involved. Well, at one point the audio they were using as the cue for the skit failed. They just kind of paused for technical difficulties. But this one girl from the planning committee started singing a random Disney song a cappella while improvising a dance to go along with it, I guess as a distraction from them trying to fix the audio. She kept trying to get people to join in with her, but nobody did, and she eventually just kind of trailed off mid-song and started pouting that nobody would sing with her. Then once they got the audio fixed for the skit, she pouted and snapped the way through the rest of her lines. which made everything even more uncomfortable. The other famous one was when a girl in our class running for student government referenced a hashtag that she was trying to make popular during her campaign speech to the whole school. The hashtag was something catchy about her having a big ass. There was a genuine collective yikes from the crowd when she said it. I don't think she got elected. This one happened a few months ago only actually. We were in law and entrepreneurship class and we had to make a presentation about a made-up company we would invent, and the two class clowns made their presentation about a drink, and their slogan was, if she's drunk she can't say no, and neither of them wanted to read it. They just wanted to skip over it. But the professor made them read it and asked them to go back to their places. I had never seen someone so calm and angry at the same time. When the class started hesitatingly clapping, the professor said, stop, this isn't worth clapping for. The next week, the two of them went around all the classes during the morning reading time to present a video about consent. TLDR, two idiots made a rape joke in class and the professor acted accordingly. This was my presentation, and it was about the science behind how Mountain Dew can dissolve a mouse. This was in fourth grade. Needless to say, I got some parent complaints. We had this senior talent show that a few male students could sign up for. No idea why it was only guys, or how the few people even got nominated for it, and they all had to do their own act. Some sang, some danced, some put on a funny skit. Possibilities were endless. Well, each year someone who never got told they weren't good at singing would end up on stage. One time this guy did the evolution of boy band songs and it was just below average singing for, no joke, 15 minutes straight. Bonus skit that I'm glad didn't stop because it was hilarious. One guy did a wrestling skit with different movie characters and my friend was the announcer. When Indiana Jones got into the ring, my friend announced, it's the BDSM bad boy himself, and somehow that slipped by all the school staff members and made it into the DVDs the school sold. Another friend of mine sang Disney princess songs while wearing a Sonic hat and got second place. And at least three girls gave him their number. Not sure if this counts, but it's something that I was a part of. We used to go to this one church that would do a Bible bee every year. Kinda like a spelling bee, except you memorize Bible verses. Normally the way this worked is that you would be given a list of verses that you would recite privately in front of 2 to 3 judges. And afterwards you had the option to do so in front of a live audience. I think you got bonus points for it or something. Being an introvert, I would always choose not to recite verses in front of a live audience. But I didn't mind, because I still got second and third place respectively during my first two runs. Yay me. On my third run, things seemed normal at first. Then when it came time for the live demonstrations, things started to get weird. A lot of the kids who were being called up were really struggling with their verses. Some requiring a prompt after every other word, or even having to move on to the next verse because they apparently hadn't memorized it at all. It was already painful to watch as I was sitting in my pew. Then things went from bad to worse as my name was called. At first I thought I was hearing things. Since I had not volunteered to do the live show today or any day prior. But to my horror, I quickly realized that I now had to do the one thing I had hoped to avoid. Things only went downhill from there. Half of the verses they told me to recite weren't even on the list I was given. And I struggled with the ones I did know due to stage fright. I forget what my score was, but it was arguably the most embarrassing experience I've ever had. I later found out that one of the women in charge, let's call her Jane, had previously suggested that all of the kids do the live show. My mom, who's friends with Jane, told her that it was probably a bad idea to make kids do something they didn't want to do. Jane complied not and said that she would run things like normal. My mom, and I assume several other parents, had a stern conversation with Jane afterwards. And I never participated in the Bible Bee again. Edit 1, just to be clear. Not all of the kids participated in the Bible Bee. I only stopped doing it because of this debacle. Edit 2. Wow, I can't believe how many people responded. Thank you for all the comments. Edit 3. I should also mention that my mom and Jane have since made up and are still good friends. 2 come to mind. Rural public school in Kansas. Speaker comes to talk to us before prom. Very clear that it's an abstinence-only speaker. Talked about our diamond zones, the crotch area for men. The whole torso from crotch to neck for women. And how we shouldn't let people touch us in our diamond zones. Because that's where our secret treasure is. Wickedly smart student in my physics class was giving a presentation on event horizons. Was actually really interesting. Definitely knew his stuff. Then, in the last third of the presentation, he starts talking about how the time dilations around event horizons can actually explain why fossils are carbon dated wrong, and that it can help us prove that the dates in the Bible actually line up with science. It was actually somewhat entertaining to see just how quickly he went off the rails.